What's going on, everyone? My name is Kellen Reck, and today I'm going to show you a quick tutorial on how to time remap in Adobe Premiere Pro. Time remapping is incredibly useful when dealing with all types of footage. It looks great in a lot of different scenarios. Today I want to go over two specific uses for this technique. So the first one, at my job with the Red Sox, I shoot a lot of high frame rate action footage. So I have an example here of a pitch shot at 240 frames per second, which is basically 10 times slower than normal motion. So we're going to use time remapping to make this look a lot more exciting. So if you look at the clip I have here, what you want to do is take the chunk of the clip that you're going to use, bring it into your sequence. So I have right here 45 seconds of a clip, already in slow motion. It's just a pitch. All right, so you want to expand the sequence here so you can see the height better here, which just hold down Option and scroll on the wheel of your mouse and you make this bigger. All right, so now see this little effects button here? If you right click on that, you get a toggle that opens up and you want to go to time remapping. Click speed. This is basically going to change your option here of what you're adjusting from opacity to speed. That's going to allow us to time remap. Now, right now we're at 100% speed, and that 100% is our slowed down footage. So what I like to do is first scroll along to where I want to see the remap. So I'm going to go right to where he's throwing the ball. And if I hit P, I get my pen tool. I can set a keyframe right here. Now, if I scroll in, what I can do is drag this out so that I actually get a little selector here. So now I've got a keyframe right here, and on either side I'm at 100% speed. Well, I want this first chunk to go a lot faster. I want it to be normal speed. So I'm going to take this from 100% and bring it all the way up to 1000, because remember, our 240 frame footage is 10 times slower than our normal footage. Now if I go into my little keyframe here, I can just move this to make it sort of a nice little ease into our speed. So now if we watch what we have, we've got the fast into slow, and then right after he swings, I wanted to speed up again. So I just set my little mark, bring this up to 1000%, and then go in and make my time ramp right here. Easy as that. Now let's watch it back. Fast into slow into fast. Now what you can do is, if you don't like how quickly this drop in speed is, you can actually go in and really ramp it out so that it transfers over a longer period of time. Just perfect where it happens. And now let's watch that back. See, it slows down a lot smoother there. And you can really play with all these time remappings in a nice, easy manner. So the second technique for the time remapping has to do with video edits. So what I'll do is, when I have a montage, there are certain places that I'll use this remapping technique. So I have an example here that's two shots, and the key to these two shots working well with this is that they're both moving the same direction. So there's motion in the frame. This shot is moving from left to right, and this shot is moving from left to right. Now what I'll do is I'll remap the speeds in the middle of the edit, and it'll almost look like a camera is jumping from one shot to the next. So let me show you what I mean here. So first I have my two shots, and we're gonna go to the first one, and we're gonna set to time remapping just as we did before. And a little bit closer to the end of the clip, I'm going to set a keyframe. Now I'm going to make my clip shoot up in speed, and I'll just go to 1000% here. So you see my clip will launch very quickly at the end. Now on my second clip, I'm going to do the same technique with the front end of my clip. So it's going to start really fast and then go into a slower motion. So now if we watch the clips back, because of the quick speed, it makes it feel as though the camera's jumping to the next clip. And it's a super easy technique that you can use in a lot of footage. Let me do another example here for you.
Let's go. Walk it like I talk it. Walk it. Walk it like I talk it. Walk it like I talk it.
So this is just a quick trick that works really well when you're putting together montages or wanting to make slow motion footage look a lot more exciting. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like down below, write a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. I post videos every Wednesday at 10 a.m. with the goal of helping you become a better filmmaker and photographer. So thanks again for watching, and don't forget to go out there and make something.